Today we're talking about or discuss with, is it possible that in a linear regression, a single variable is significant but has a low R-square? Before we go to the math part, let's think about intuition. Let's take a simple case, single variate regression. If we regress y on x, and we got y equal to x times beta plus a noise, statistical significance means that if there is a unit change in x, so if the delta of x equal to 1, would lead to a unit beta change. So the delta of y will equal to beta. And a given confidence interval, let's say 95%, means that if we sample 100 times, in 95% of the total 100 samples, the y will change within a range, and this range does not contain 0. And in other 5% of total 100 samples, the y does not change. Of course, there's a range there, but we can regard it, the delta of y will be close to 0. For single variable regression, R-square is simply the square of Pearson correlation between y and x. So the R-square will be equal to the rho square between x and y, which measure how much y's change can be explained by x. Now let's see whether it's possible for a single variable to have low R-square but very significant. We know from OLS, ordinary least square estimator beta hat, the beta hat will equal to x transpose times x inverse x transpose times y. In single variable regression, we can simplify it equal to covariance of xy divided by variance of x. And we can simplify it further, which is equal to the correlation between x and y times the ratio of standard deviation y divided by standard deviation of x. And to know whether it is significant, we need another measure, which is the variance of the beta hat. So in single variable, it is the residue square, sum of the residue square divided by n minus 1. So the t statistics will become the OLS expected value divided the standard deviation of your estimator. So to make it significant, we want this guy as large as possible. So we can make the denominator smaller by changing this guy. By make the denominator larger by changing smaller, by let the sum of square residue smaller, and make the number of observations larger. So in this case, we can make the beta hat significant. In the same time, we need to make the R-square very low. So we need to make the correlation between x and y close to 0. Let's say the correlation right now is 0.1. And 0.1 square will be equal to only 1 basis point. In the same time, we want to make sure the expected value of beta hat is significantly different from 0. Although the correlation is close to 0, we can make the standard deviation of y very large, so we can make it larger. It can be goes to positive infinity, and we can also in the same time make the standard deviation of x very smaller, and it can goes to very close to 0. So in this case, the beta hat is still significant. In an intuitive way, if a variable is significant, it means that the change of x can lead to the change of y, but if the r square is small, it means that although the change of x would change the y, the extra change of y is not mostly attributed to or because of the change of x. So here we say attributed to or because of does not mean that x and y has the causal correlation. Just a statistical language to say, hey, the change of x is due to the change of y, or the change of y is due to the change of x. So in more straightforward way, as I write here, the delta of x1, if the x1 is significant, it can contribute to the change of y. But if the r square is very low, it means that there may be some other factors like x or x1 square or sin x, some nonlinearity of x type can also contribute to the change of y. Alright, that's it, and thanks for watching this video. See you next time.